In this video, we will demonstrate how users can create a data view in AVEVA Data Hub. Additional learning resources will also be highlighted at the end of the video. Before you start, confirm your Data Hub service has been deployed and is activated. You will typically require editor access in Data Hub from a user group with the tenant contributor role. You will also have explored and defined the data that you will add to your data view. Once these steps are completed, you are ready to start creating your data view. Creating a data view is a recommended way to manage your data. A data view can help by combining your assets, metadata, and time series data into a single view that can be shared and consumed by other data tools, such as Power BI, or used via a REST API call. It also helps provide operational data with context, so it's easier for data scientists to get started on their work. A data view is also a recommended approach for efficient data collaboration. In the example that follows, we have used assets to help build our data view. However, be aware you can also use streams in data views if you choose to do so. Be aware that data streams are the current method used to share data using the communities function in Data Hub. It may also be useful to know that a data view can hold up to 100,000 data items. Start by opening Data Hub using AVEVA Connect. Explore the data you're planning to use. Streams can be viewed in data management in the sequential data store. Assets can be viewed in visualization using Asset Explorer. Make use of the search panel to filter if required. Use the tabs to explore the details. To create a new data view, select Analytics, then Data Views. From the side menu, select the Add Data View button to proceed. Start by giving your data view a suitable name. Name your query if desired. Select streams or assets depending on your requirements. Assets will be used for this example. Enter your query using available search terms. The search helps us find the assets. Review the results and select Save to continue. Enter a search for required fields in the text box, then make field selections, as shown. Select relevant fields by ticking the checkboxes. Search and select additional fields as required. You can also search and select from metadata fields, as shown. You can also add summary calculations, such as average, maximum, or minimum, as shown. Use the checkbox to select. The total number of selections is displayed on the Apply button. When you have completed your field selection, press Apply to proceed. Review your data view by using the Preview pane. To change the column order, use the left-hand pane to change field positions, as shown. The example field, Revenue Monthly Value, is selected and dragged to a new position. The Refresh Preview button is selected to update the preview displayed. The field is now displayed in the new position. Please note the data view shape function. The narrow format can be selected for your view, if required, for use in another application. Return to the standard view shape by selecting the other button, and then refresh. The time range for the preview can be edited using the function on the lower menu. You can also specify these parameters whenever you query the data view using the API. Let's change the start date as an example. You can also use the Now button to set the end time to your current time and date. Select Apply to save the change. If a change to the grouping field is required, this can be performed here. This will also change the shape of your view. The preview has been set to auto-refresh. We recommend you leave this enabled. If you wish to inspect the API console for your view, use the View in API Console link on the top menu. Details of the API call parameters can be inspected here and copied or edited if required. The Get button can be used to initiate the API query if required. When you have finished editing all aspects of your data view, select Save and Close to finish. Your new data view has now been created. For more information on data views, visit docs.aveva.com. To help with navigation on docs.aveva, select AVEVA Data Hub, then open Analytics, and then Data Views. A brief demonstration of navigating the site will follow in the next section. Visit the docs.aveva.com website. Select AVEVA Data Hub. Select Analytics. And now select Data Views. Select the appropriate section, as required. This completes our video for creating a data view in AVEVA Data Hub.